Opiate addiction. Joining me now is the Washington Free Beacon editor, Matthew Continetti. Matt, one of the things that they didn't talk about today is something you've been focused on, which is that while this attention has been focused on Syria or on North Korea, we do have an ongoing discussion about Iran and the Iran nuclear deal and the connection between that and Secretary Tillerson's firing. Your thoughts?
That's right, and you heard it, I think, Dana, in that last question about the Europeans perhaps raising the prospect of new sanctions against Iran in a bid to preserve the Obama-Iran nuclear agreement. Mm-hmm. And as you recall, that President Trump says this is the worst deal ever, and I think elevating Mike Pompeo to the Secretary of State is another sign that President Trump is very likely to end the agreement this coming May.
In addition, we have a quote from Secretary Mattis, who has been talking about what Iran is doing in the Middle East, and he said today, "We have worrisome evidence that Iran is trying to influence using money in the Iraqi elections." And so not only is Iran continuing to try to have influence in Syria, but all across the region, including in Iraq, but what also, Matthew, about Iran's connection to North Korea?
That's right. News stories about proliferation relationships between Iran and North Korea and Syria, where Iran has a huge presence. You know, every place there's mischief in the Middle East, and you said Iraq, Syria, let's not forget Yemen, where there's that awful civil war taking place. Iran's fingerprints are behind it. And this has been kind of an undercover story with the Trump administration being increasingly tough on Iran. Mm-hmm. Nikki Haley in particular raising this issue of Iran's involvement in Yemen, the drones there. There was an altercation between Israel and Iranian forces in Syria. And now I think with Pompeo, who's not only a critic of the nuclear deal, but also a critic of the repression of the Iranian government, I think he'd be a strong force for deterrence and rewriting or just tearing up that
nuclear deal. And you know, the pushback is coming from a lot of different places. Take a listen to this clip of Saudi Crown Prince bin Salman. He was questioned about Iran. And listen to what he has to say on 60 Minutes this coming weekend.
"But I've seen that you called the Ayatollah Khamenei the new Hitler of the Middle East."
"Absolutely."
"Why?"
"Because he wants to expand. He wants to create his own project in the Middle East, very much like Hitler, who wanted to expand at the time. Many countries around the world and in Europe did not realize how dangerous Hitler was until what happened. I don't want to see the same events happening in the Middle East."
I wanted to get your thoughts on that. I know you study the region closely.
Well, you know, I think it's important to remember that not only is there this external pressure from people like the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia and the Trump administration, there's also internal pressure from within Iran that we can't ignore. The Ayatollah Khamenei, who's in charge of Iran, and his ruling clique are under a lot of pressure from dissidents. Remember, they had those riots at the end of last year. Mm-hmm. The economy is in shambles. They have a banking crisis. And there are even criticisms that the Iranian foreign policy is overstretched. Iranians wondering, why is there so much attention being paid to Syria and not to the economic problems at home?
Right.
So all of these pressures are kind of coalescing into what I think will be a confrontation with Iran in the coming year.
Well, it certainly is a subject that we should pay more attention to, and we will continue to do so on the Daily Briefing and elsewhere on the Fox News Channel. Matthew Continetti, thank you.